Tonight, three VIP titans decide the fate of our rising entrepreneurs, determined to prove their greatness in 60 seconds or less.
I was off put by her energy here.
They don't need any money. Why are they here?
Without that expertise, it really scares me.
What just happened?
This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business, with support from State Farm and Canon. Meet our board of investors. Nicole Walters, CEO of Inherit Learning Company. Mark Randolph, co-founder and first CEO of Netflix. Kim Perrell, marketing mogul and tech CEO of 100.co. First to enter the elevator, an entrepreneur who plans to transform the lives of women everywhere with innovative biomedical technology.
Going up. Hello, Mary Beth. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Oh, hello. More women use IUDs for contraception than the pill. But IUD pain is a serious issue. Some describe it as absolutely horrific. Even so, the worldwide market for IUDs is close to $5 billion. Current IUDs, and I'm Mary Beth Cicero, CEO of Three Daughters. We're developing drugs for women's health, starting with IUD pain. Current IUDs have a T-shaped frame with a T-shaped plastic frame with arms and a dangling strings. Our IUD is based on physics and conforms to a woman's body. We are looking to complete our raise with a $600,000 investment, structured as a safe with a 20% discount.
Yikes.
Oh, I hate to see that.
That was terrible.
There was one point where I actually thought, oh, is she recovering? You know, and then it was just, that pitch was terrible.
Did you think that she, enough to let her into the boardroom, or?
It's one of those things where you're weighing the presentation versus interest in the product.
Mm-hmm. Let's vote.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Oh, Mary Beth, Mary Beth.
You barely made it out of there.
I know.
What happened?
I'm so passionate about this.
We can tell.
And I practically said this in my sleep, and I've been dreaming, actually, about being in front of you three.
Well, you're here now. So congratulations.
Thank you.
For making it out of the elevator. We have many questions, but you're here. We just want you to take a breath.
Thank you.
Because we've seen many, many pitches. It's normal to be nervous. Mm-hmm. However, your market opportunity is there. And we just want to hear a little bit more about why you. Why are you perfectly positioned to solve this problem?
I took a line from Mark of, you know, yes, that luck is opportunity met with preparation. I have been in consulting for the last 20 years, have seen a million opportunities, and when this came along, I became enthralled. And the reason why is for women's health, which is my passion, for our daughters, which is legacy, which is you are all about, and it's where I felt that I could add value.
In case you didn't know, the ladies are the ones who got you up here.
Mark,
why'd you turn it down?
Do not play the gender card
on me. It's true.
Here.
She called the quote, but yet we're the ones who did the vote.
Okay, but wait a second.
Mark, excuse me.
The thing that I found a problem was I didn't understand what it was you were bringing here. And I need to understand before I'm willing to engage. So help me understand.
This is the current product that has been on the market since 1988. Okay. It pretty much looks the same way. This is our product. And you're right, Mark, because investors do get very confused because it looks like a device, it acts like a device, but it's regulated as a drug because it uses copper as a spermicide. And copper has been proven in over 40 years of use. I talk to women, almost every woman I run into remembers IUD pain. This is a huge market. I said 5 billion. In the US, it's over 1 billion. A little company isn't going to take that on. We want to partner with the big guys. We're taking this to the point in development where we've proven all of the, you know, the really, the endpoints that a big pharmaceutical would need to know.
Do you have to go through trials?
Yes. And the contraceptive trials are extensive.
And expensive. How long will $600,000 last you? Or what's the total raise that you're looking to?
We're looking for 1.2. We've raised half of it.
Okay.
Okay, I love the preparation. It's fantastic.
I agree.
I can tell you right now, I am so far out, it's crazy. Let me just quickly explain why. I mean, number one, trials scare the pants off of me in terms of the expense. Because of the expense, the uncertainty.
But our first trial isn't that expensive.
I'm very, very concerned, especially how early you are. And it concerns me that basically it's also, in a sense, just trying to get it to a point where it gets bought by a larger pharmaceutical. These are all things I'm sure defensible. They are just so far outside of my expertise, understanding, and interest that I've got to, I'm going to turn it over to our experts.
Well, I wanted
here.
To leave with three just because I thought you might want to consider your daughters. But I mean, that's the Warren Buffett advice, right? Don't invest in something that you don't fully understand. But
I mean, I'm with Mark. I love your passion. I actually believe in in changing the game and doing things differently. But to Mark's point, it's so early and it's so outside my wheelhouse as well that I'm going to pass.
I love that I can tell that you are passionate, and I definitely can tell that you do your due diligence when it comes to researching who you're going to pitch, and all those things are really important to be able to convey your product. The issue is, I don't invest in a product that doesn't exist, and that's kind of where we are right now, is that you'd be asking us all to invest in an idea, and at this point, I'm not even sure if the idea is that rock solid. Let me explain, because I know you're like, it is rock solid. It makes so much sense. Look at the numbers. Look at the opportunity. I'm with you on that. I am an IUD user, so I can actually say I'll put all my business out here. I have an IUD. I know the pain of which you speak, but I also know that market-wise, there are already things that are well into trials because I had something that was a newer model, and they're already solving that problem. So, I mean, you are so far behind on development already that an entirely new concept just has leaps and bounds to go before it can be a competitive player in the market space. So I'm concerned because it's going to take a lot of money to even see this become viable. And even then, I'm just so concerned that right now we're waving something that doesn't even really exist. It's just an idea in your hand.
It does exist. It's not an idea.
An idea, it's just not validated. And I understand that you're looking for money for that validation, but it's kind of one
of those
things.
Well, it's not the money for the validation, it's the money to move it into manufacturing.
Okay.
Basically.
So I understand that.
And copper, I just want to add one simple thing.
I appreciate you, Mary Beth, and I think, unfortunately, I think we're at a place right now where it's just a flat no from all three of us.
Okay.
And while we can appreciate that, you know, it seems like it's one more thing, I just don't think that you're going to get the yes from us here. So we appreciate your passion. We wish you the best.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so
much.
Good luck.
Okay. Thank you.
Good luck.
Appreciate it. I was warned that the investors on these shows do not totally understand, you know, pharmaceutical development, that it's long and expensive, and I want them to know our plans inside and out. We have everything planned down to the wire, and we're all about execution, and to do that in a 1-minute pitch in a 5-minute conversation is probably not the way to go, and I guess this is what was proven to me.
I totally agree it's not the right stage.
Mm-hmm.
I totally agree about us being outside of our wheelhouse. I never really heard the case.
And yeah. I honestly think a lot of the things, and I mean, call me a feeler, but not only was I off-put by her pitch, I was off-put by her energy here. You know, I understand the passion.
Oh, I kind of liked it. She got more aggressive.
She did get more aggressive.
Like, she showed a little bit of gump in the elevator. I thought she was going to fall over.
That is true. She didn't seem like she was going to pass out like she did in the elevator. But I think that her inability to listen to the why and her quickness to defensiveness means we're going to run into problems around improving that product because she's so hell-bent on it being exactly the way she sees it. And that's going to be an issue. I don't want to invest in someone I can't work with.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Bringing the energy to the elevator is our next set of entrepreneurs and their portable method for a healthy boost.
Going up. Hello, Ori and Chaim. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name's Ori, this is Chaim, and we're the founders of Vay Labs. At Vay, we are a team of neuroscientists developing the most convenient, fast-acting, and affordable way to take supplements and medicine. Our first product, Vay Energy, uses our patent-pending nitro caffeine to deliver a coffee's worth of clean, focused energy in just 3 sprays. While an energy drink takes up to an hour to kick in, Vay works in minutes. And unlike energy drinks, Vay has 0 sugars, 0 calories, and includes key amino acids derived from matcha that reduce caffeine jitters while amping up your focus and your energy. After establishing our first market with our first product, we'll utilize our spray technology to expand into both the pharmaceutical and supplement markets. We're currently wrapping up our pre-seed round and are looking for an additional $400,000 on an $8 million pre-money save. Thank you, and we would love to have you join as partners on our journey.
Oh, quite the pitch. I will say there are 2 things that stood out to me there. 1, the other guy's just a prop. And 2, that guy seems like he doesn't need his own product at all. He had the jitters.
Or I was going to say, that other guy needs a few shots.
Yes, yes. Like, really, he needs to take 3 sprays. And I want to see it, actually.
That's
he
right.
needs to get in and instant. We'll see what he's got.
But in all seriousness, I mean, I think this type of product is actually attractive. So I kind of want to hear how they're structuring it. And they seem to have big dreams.
And I agree with Mark. There's probably a big market opportunity. 3 seconds, 3 sprays.
You guys ready?
All right, let's go.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Let's go.
Let's go.
Welcome to the boardroom.
So the big question is, how wired must you guys be right now?
Or
I mean, you've probably been hitting the stuff all day, huh?
Yeah, that's right.
All the time, testing.
But still no jitters, right?
No jitters, yeah, exactly.
So is that really a pharmaceutical-y level kind of no jitters thing, or is this was there science behind this?
So our formula is based on matcha, which uses L-theanine, L-tyrosine, and the caffeine to create a more focused and clean energy without the jitters and crash.
So is this like an adaptogen type product? Because, you know, like neurotropics are all the rage right now. Everyone's trying to figure out some way to hack their brains. I mean, does this have some of that going on?
So L-theanine and L-tyrosine are both amino acids, mm-hmm. and they're both considered nootropics. So they help you really focus and dial in. So it's more than just the caffeine. You've also got those ingredients in there as well.
What progress have you made? Do you actually have products in the market yet? Is it still under development? Have you sold anything?
We have sold previously, so about 2 years ago we did an Indiegogo campaign. We sold around $55,000 USD in a 2-month period. Since then we've been going straight onto product development, just going all on taste, all making sure everything's perfect. Ran into a bunch of issues that first time, so we definitely learned our lesson. And then since then we've been progressing a ton. We've been doing our round for the last couple of months. We met some awesome investors. Now we've got a really good team around us. Not just us two, but like a whole team with investors and, you know, a whole bunch of people to help us out in the areas where we lack experience.
And how much are you raising?
Probably around like just over $1 million.
Just over $1 million.
Yeah.
And you're looking for $400 today.
Yeah.
Yes.
And how much you have committed?
750, so that gets us right there.
Yeah. No, all this stuff sounds good and great. Like, I love that you guys are clearly, they were far more eager to get you up here.
Okay.
No shade, doesn't mean I don't love it. I'm into the taste. Does this taste like trash? That's what I really want to know. Because, I mean, they're all, it'll sell, all that. Mark's easy. Mark likes to give away money. This is his favorite thing to do. So
yeah, the taste was super important for us. Because, like, if you think about it, like, no one can get the caffeine at the level we have.
Oh, don't explain it. Let me try it.
Yeah, go for it.
So I see there are two different types here. Because, obviously, I'm the one who needs the caffeine, right? Like, I'm the one who needs to buzz a little more. Not hit me up. Mark, you have a past? what was this like? You're telling on yourself. It's about to get a little intimate. Ready? I gotcha.
And she's gonna give a buzz to my cheek. But, oh, that's pretty good.
All right, I'll try.
But since only two went in my mouth,
we've been working on it.
You can just say three. It's all good.
But the taste is something that we were saying is super important for us, because for us, the taste at first was awful. We've been working on this for over 5 years
pretty
at this
good.
Point.
It is actually pretty good.
Took us 2 years to get the product development to, like, the caffeine where it needed to be, and then 3 years to get the taste where it needed to be.
Because caffeine is super bitter, so the taste is actually a really big point for our product. Yeah.
So not to get too geeky, but let me get geeky. I mean, this is caffeine, and how many milligrams of caffeine are in a dose in three shots?
Yeah, so each spray is 22.5 milligrams, and three is 67.5.
Holy mackerel.
What's in a standard cup of coffee?
Yeah, don't exceed 15.
Coffee's 70 to 120 typically, and that's really what sets us apart, because without our patent-pending formula, you wouldn't be able to do more than 2 to 3 milligrams per spray, which would make caffeine sprays non-functional. So we're the first functional caffeine spray.
What is actually your marketing strategy? Mm-hmm. Are you going to go to D2C? Are you going to go to retail? Like, do you have a partnership in place? Have you done a proof of concept?
Yeah, so we're going to start off D2C, so doing like 3 to 6 months of D2C, and getting a lot of consumer feedback. So feedback on the product, feedback on the marketing, getting our like key value props really dialed in. And then we're going to be looking to go into retail. And we have connections through our advisors in New York. And we'll probably start with a suburb of New York and then another smaller city.
What sort of retail? What are you thinking? Gas stations, Walgreens, college bookstores?
All that stuff and more. Gyms, pharmacies.
That was free advice. Write that down.
The way we're thinking about it is we want to go like region by region and saturate those regions. Because with a product like ours, you see people walking around with it and using it. So once you see it on the shelves, you're like, oh, okay, this is what it is. They want to try it. And we think retail is really where we're going to succeed. But we want to do that D2C run just so we have a strong idea of like where our product's at, if we're ready to go to retail, and then launch very slowly. And then eventually expand to retail.
So this strikes me much more as being an influencer-driven product rather than a truck stop and gas station product.
100%.
I mean, I see elite athletes using this. I see people who basically say, I really have a need for this. And that's difficult because a lot of people are clamoring for those endorsements. So I really like the product. But to tell you the truth, product is not what drives this type of product. It's almost entirely marketing. Mm-hmm. I mean, this is a category where people sell water and figure out different ways to position water, different ways to make it attractive. And without that expertise, it really scares me.
Yeah, I'm with Mark. I've literally in the last 2 years have launched 3 consumer brands. So knowing how your product actually I love, even though my heart is beating literally out of my chest. So, but I like the product. I think it's easy. I'm a mom of 4. I can see it on the go. I can put it in my purse. I can, you know, wherever I am, you can have it. I like it. I like it. But I do think getting the eyes of the consumer is so hard right now. So that marketing strategy has to be so spot on in order to be able to scale and, you know, actually differentiate yourself from so many other companies looking for those same eyeballs. Based on how hard it is that I know to get a business off the ground, it's gonna be challenging, but I wish you all the best.
Okay, well, I appreciate it.
If you had come in and said, we have the expertise, we have the expertise in positioning a consumer product, I would have been all in.
Yeah.
I really do like the product.
Yeah.
I think there is a spot for this type of thing, but I'm not all in. But again, I have a real FOMO thing going on here.
Okay.
So I'd love to be part of the round, but it's gonna be in a relatively small ways. I would do $50,000 at that valuation just to be
cheap.
Along for the ride.
I'm so sorry.
I left plenty of room for Nicole to take the risk.
Okay, that's what it is. Well, look, I'm interested. This is something that I would absolutely support. I just feel like I will actually match his 50, but I'll also say that I will bring a bunch of influencers with me.
We were just talking, we'd be happy to take both of you if you guys are both interested in coming in together on it.
I'm okay with that.
fine. I like beating Mark. You've stolen my joy. Yeah. You know what I mean? Just tell me that it was actually me that you wanted.
And hearing that Nicole's willing to throw her influences behind it makes me even more comfortable making the investment.
You see so that? He'll always awesome. Put money behind a pretty face. Come hither. Shove the product in my hands. Yes, thank you so much. Yeah. Absolutely.
Thanks.
Congratulations. Of course, you deserve.
Getting Nicole and Mark was exactly what we wanted. Getting the two of them, both in terms of Mark's, you know, expertise and what he's done, and then Nicole's influencer, like being an influencer and having influencer connections, just completely changes the game for us.
In all seriousness, those guys were actually pretty good.
They were pretty good, yeah.
But they really have to get some marketing expertise.
Absolutely.
Oh, very.
You've got to pair the two.
I will admit, I'm a little nervous about the fact that they had to halt production. And while I'm excited to be behind it, I cannot wait to go through the due diligence process with them because I think that's going to reveal a lot. Entrepreneurs get so excited about their great idea or their signature product, but they forget that none of those things matter without rock solid marketing. You need to understand your customer demographic. You need to understand your profit margins. All these things matter if you're actually gonna have a business, because if you don't understand marketing, you don't have anything to sell.
Looking to walk away with a deal is our next entrepreneur, whose footwear brand is built for any terrain.
My name is Jordan, and I'm the founder of Dooeys. What inspired me to start Dooeys was just seeing a gap in the market. I was tired of wearing ugly, unsupportive slippers, and I was like, there's gotta be something better out there, something with style and actual foot support, and I couldn't find it, so I decided to create it.
Going up. Hello, Jordan. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Jordan, the founder of Dooeys, a brand reimagining slippers for modern home life by creating the slip shoe. The perfect combination of a cozy slipper and a stylish yet supportive shoe made from sustainable, plant-based, and recycled materials. Our customers rave about our slip shoes, and we've been rated the best overall slipper by House Beautiful. We've achieved a 69% gross margin based on landed costs and an average order value of $149. We're ready to grow and seeking mentorship and $150,000 in the form of a safe note with a $4 million cap that we'll use towards marketing, inventory, and developing new styles, including a men's collection. So join us in being a positive change in the fashion industry, enabling men, women, and kids to look good, feel good, and do good for the planet with every step they take at home. Thank you.
Wow.
I'm not going to be mad. That was an excellent pitch.
Yeah.
I was just going to say the same thing. That was an
really
excellent
good.
Pitch. I mean, she covered all the bases. I mean, do you have any first impressions?
I don't know how much $150K is going to get
I was
get
just going to say that.
Develop shoes.
Well, I mean, the laundry list of stuff that she said she wanted for $150K, I was like, girl, I was like, that's not anywhere near. I mean. Yeah.
And I also got the impression that she was already underway. I mean, mm-hmm. she's the best rated shoe in Home Beautiful.
Right.
But why only $150K? And it sounds like a mismatch of where they are and what they're trying to accomplish. Well, let's vote.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been denied.
Obviously, I'm bummed, but I'm so grateful for this opportunity and just to be here to share my brand and have the, you know, chance to pitch to such amazing investors. So, you know, I gotta walk away happy with that.
Well, I was looking for alignment and we got close. Looks like we had two no's, but a yes?
Yeah, a yes for me, because I am the mom who's at home who has to run to the bus stop. Like, the idea of slip shoes speaks to me, but I will say this would elevate my sweatpants wardrobe to a level that probably it shouldn't be seen, so.
I liked her tenacity. She had a great pitch, but her ask for $150,000 is not gonna get her outside the elevator. Mm-hmm. So it's time to move on. Let's see the next pitch.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Entering the elevator is a master of flavor who hopes to bring Jamaican spice to stores worldwide.
My name is Kamal Jarrett. My company is Hillside Harvest. Hillside Harvest is about just trying new things. We cater to just about everyone, every type of palate. Our goal is to be as inclusive as possible when it comes to food, while also giving you an experience that's unique and different from what you may have had before.
Going up. Hello, Kamal. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hello, my name is Kamal Jarrett, founder of Hillside Harvest, a Caribbean-American sauce and condiment company focused on crafting delicious products that highlight Caribbean flavors and culture. Since launching in 2019, we've seen really great traction regionally, growing over 130% on average year over year. We've also been able to really connect with some awesome partners like Whole Foods Market and Fresh Direct. We think that there's tons of opportunity within the sauce and condiment market. It's a $22 billion market, and we still have a long way to go. Today, we're asking for $300,000 in a safe note in order to build our team, increase our distribution, and focus on high profitable areas such as food service and direct to consumer. I hope that you'll have a chance to taste our sauces and hear more about our brand. Thank you.
Spicy?
If there was anything I've ever wanted in my life, it was for Mark to turn to me and just say spicy. That's all I ever wanted. I feel like it's all complete.
It was a good pitch, though,
right? It was
right?
A strong pitch.
Yeah.
And I have to say, I'm partial to sauces. Like, your kids are always looking for something for them to dip in. And
yeah, he's got great traction with two major retailers.
Absolutely.
To me, that's a good sign.
That's a good start.
Absolutely. But if you've been in the supermarket lately, the shelf with the hot sauces on it is 250 feet long. It has to be one of the most crowded categories, and I didn't really hear necessarily how he was going to differentiate himself.
Let's vote.
Let's vote.
Attention. The boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
All right. Yes. Welcome to the boardroom.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for calling me up.
I am interested in hearing more, tasting more. Sell us your sauce.
Absolutely. So we launched way back in 2019 with just two sauces. And since then, we've kind of grown the product line, really trying to create an element of something for everyone. So our pineapple Fresno is our lightest sauce, maybe like a 3 out of 10 for hot sauce. And then we have our sun-kissed tomato, which you'll be trying today, which is more medium heat. And that was really something that was asked for by the consumer. They wanted something a little bit more savory. And so we launched our sun-kissed tomato. And then our original was the OG that was here from the beginning. That's more like a 7 out of 10. And that is unbelievable. It's scotch bonnet, apple, honey, ginger, lemon juice, garlic, so tons of flavor. And that's really what we position on, is providing not just a culturally different positioning for our sauces, but also we lead with flavor. So that's what we think we have is in terms of a differentiator.
One thing that leapt out at me during your pitch, which was good, by the way, was the fact that you were going to approach food service.
Absolutely.
Tell me about that.
Absolutely. So we think that there's a ton of opportunity within food service. We could essentially double our revenue today by just attacking hospitals, schools, places like those. We're based out of Boston, and so there's an endless amount of hospitals and schools for us to connect with. And not only is it a great place to get penetration, but it's also marketing for us. And then there's not as much lift as there is with wholesale. You don't have to do free fills. You don't have to do tastings. It's really just plug and play. And so the profitability is a lot better as well. So by putting some investment that way, we're not only gaining revenue, but we're also gaining profitability because it's such a great revenue stream.
Well, I like profitability, and I also like your growth numbers. So I'd love to hear a little bit more about how much you've made in 19, 20, and what's your projection for next year?
So in 19, we were about 70,000 in revenue. In 20, we grew to about 180, and we're reaching this year for about 300. We may fall. That was our stretch goal, and we're still achievable. But we've seen tremendous growth year over year, and we're really just a regional player today, right? So there's still a ton of opportunity if we scale.
And how many stores are you in right now?
Currently, we're in 225, mostly within the Northeast, but also we have a chain in the Midwest as well.
What does your manufacturing look like? Because I know that you guys are growing and everything, but what is the vision? Because that 300,000 you're asking for, it sounds like you were saying it was going to go towards marketing, things like that. How are you going to actually fulfill if we're able to get this thing across the nation?
So we do work with a co-packer. We actually have two co-packers at the moment, and we're probably only at about 25% capacity with them. So we have quite a bit of room to scale within that. In starting out, so I have a history working with Keurig Dr. Pepper. That was my background. Okay. So I knew right from the front I wanted to set up with a co-packer. Even while I was producing myself, we were interviewing co-packers to be ready for opportunities like this. And so we've been with our co-packer for about 2 years, and we're ready to move on or move further with them. And so they'd be ready and waiting for any kind of opportunity that came with scale.
We gotta try this.
I was like making me profile.
My mouth water.
Now I'm like, I know that Mark buys anything he thinks is delicious. So all we have to do is sell him on it.
Absolutely. Let's try some.
I'm so excited to see everyone's face. I'm like, let's do this.
Yeah.
All right, we're diving in.
So I'll pour you guys a little.
All right. Here, I'll be your assistant, so you don't have to stop your pitch. All right.
Absolutely.
This is it. Mark, here you go.
Oh, what a cool. How nice of you. Thank you.
You're so welcome.
That's so nice.
Kim, please.
Thank you. I'm so thrilled.
Absolutely delicious. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. All right.
We want you to enjoy these and find new ways to enjoy your favorite foods. And so you really can, there's
so
really
good.
No, thank you.
And the heat comes.
Yeah, on the back end, right?
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Okay, flavor?
Yeah.
Yes!
That's my point, right, is that we're a flavor factory first and foremost, right? So we want people to try these with everything and anything that they like.
Okay, so you know when you go to a bar and you see all the vodkas, they're all in exotic shaped bottles. Mm-hmm. When you go to buy perfume, which I don't do very often, they're all in exotic shaped bottles. Mm-hmm. Even water is in exotic shaped bottles. But why is every single hot sauce in that damn same container?
You're
missing
right.
This opportunity to differentiate yourself.
So really it comes down to not just the volume of which these are produced, but also the process in which hot sauce is made. So you're heating things up to maybe 200 degrees and then filling them into the bottle. You want something that's sturdy enough to hold. But that being said, yes, you could design a different glass bottle that could hold something. That would take maybe additional investment if you're interested.
It springs just from my concern, and I aired this before you emerged, was that the hot sauce category is so crowded.
It
I
is.
Mean, now it's so many products, they're all fighting for shelf space, fighting for consumer attention. I'll jump right out there and go, investing in a consumer packaged good, especially in a highly competitive category, scares me. So I'll be a customer, I'm just gonna pass on being an investor.
Absolutely, I appreciate that. Yeah.
Well, I'm impressed. I'm impressed with both the product and the person.
You
are impressive. I guess my question is, what's the valuation?
We were hoping to be uncapped for now, until we don't wanna necessarily pigeonholed us, and we want to increase our value. So we're looking for a safe note for future valuation because we are so early in our process.
I'll give you $300 for 10% at a $3 million valuation.
Okay.
I believe in you.
All right.
But I want enough stake that it makes it worth my while.
That's a fair enough value.
I'm leaning back till
Should
sparks
I turn?
Fly.
Yeah, turn around.
Yeah,
turn around. Don't look.
I would be okay with that. Yeah,
for sure.
Okay, all right. So, I personally feel like if you need any support, I think Kim's offer is a strong one. And not just because I know you'll do the work to capitalize on it, but I also think it's just the beginning.
Absolutely.
And Kim has resources. So it's not just about, you know, the money on the base level. It's the fact that if she says yes, she's gonna give it her all, because Kim likes to get her money back, but she also likes to see people win. So I feel like that is a really great offer, and you'd be crazy to walk out and not accept it. But to kind of sweeten the deal, or spicy the deal, if you will. I also think that on behalf of Amazon Business, we'd all like to give you a grant of $10,000.
Wow.
That you will get scot-free to be able to use to invest in your business, to just go ahead and put towards growing, revamping. I mean, that's halfway to your marketing budget.
Thank you so much. That's amazing.
We have an opportunity to give that to anyone we think stands out, and you definitely do.
My goodness, that's awesome. Mm-hmm. And I would love to accept your offer.
All right, we're all partners.
Let's do it, Kim.
Amazing.
Congratulations. Game
time. Can we shake hands?
Yes.
Thank
What's
you
important
so much.
To it, yes.
Absolutely, absolutely.
I love this.
All right, guys.
High five, I'm in it.
Should I get my
so
free
much.
Samples from
yes,
her?
Yes.
I'm in it for the hot dog. It's a win.
You can take that home.
Absolutely. That's right.
Working with Kim is going to be an amazing experience. She brings a ton to the table in terms of marketing. She's scaled tons of companies before, so I think she can help us right where we are today get to where we want to be, you know, 2, 3, 5 years down the line.
I think he was incredible, and sometimes you just have to take a chance. And taking a chance on him, I think, is going to pay off tenfold.
The most important advice I can give you in pitching is simply this: be yourself. I'm not investing in technology, cash flow, or market share. I'm investing in you. So if you can't come off as being credible, competent, and in control, you've lost before you've even started.
Hey guys, love you, how are you?
Hey guys, you ready?
Yeah, we're very excited. We're so pumped.
You guys worked so hard. We're so proud of you. I hope you guys kill it.
I'm so proud of him too.
We're proud of you.
Well, we love you guys and thank you so much.
Love you.
We're gonna crush it.
Have a good one. Good luck.
Bye.
Last to enter the elevator, two grill masters are looking to flip the outdoor cooking experience.
Going up. Hello, Scott and Anthony. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
I'm Anthony.
And I'm Scott, a full-time firefighter and co-founder of Grill Rescue.
In addition to being frustrated, there's simply no good way to clean your grill. There's also a huge problem with grill brushes.
The bristles!
The bristles from your old metal grill brush are falling off and can inhibit your food.
As a firefighter, we see hospitalizations far too often, and we want to put a stop to that for good.
We created Grill Rescue, the best and safest way to clean your grill. Just heat up your grill, dunk Grill Rescue in water, and watch as the steam magically pulverizes any caked on gunk.
We launched Grill Rescue in June 2019 and ran out of inventory 5 times and still managed to gross over $22 million in sales.
Not to mention, we donate directly to first responders in need. Clearly, people love Grill Rescue.
We're here seeking $0 for 3% of our company. Yes, you heard that correct.
Who's ready to throw out their old grill brush and save some lives?
Nice.
Ahead of schedule.
Well, I love the enthusiasm, but Ed, that was a great pitch.
Did they say $22 million in sales, sold out 5 times?
It's amazing.
And that they want $0, so.
Why are they here?
It did a few great things here. I mean, number one, it was compelling, but it certainly raised some curiosity in me.
Thank you, great pitch. But if they don't need any money, why are they here?
Why are they even here? You wanted to be on TV, you got it.
Are they wasting our time, in other words?
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes. Did it, man, yeah! Love you, brother.
Love you, man.
Yes. Jeff.
So, gentlemen, welcome to the boardroom.
Thank you.
I just will say that burning smell you may have picked up was from our last entrepreneur's hot sauce. And that was a great pitch.
Amazing.
It was compelling and interesting. But before you even weighed in, I got to ask, Nicole, what was your problem?
My problem, the reason I didn't say yes right out of the gate was I don't know what you want. I mean, you have a business that's thriving. You are clearly charismatic and you can sell your pants off literally. So what I don't understand is why you would even take money from investors when you clearly are doing this yourself.
Yeah, so we've done really good on our own. You know, like he mentioned, we've raised $22 million, but we're really here seeking a strategic partner and a mentor. I mean, everybody in this room shares something in common. Their drive, their mentality, and ultimately their discomfort. Mm-hmm. I mean, no one got to where they are by being comfortable and staying stagnant. Scott and I each invested $2,000 when we started this company in 2019. And in 3 short years, we've managed to do over $22 million in sales. Mm-hmm. We know what it's like to run a $10 million business, but you guys know what it's like to run $100 million businesses. We believe with your expertise, we can help bridge that gap between $10 and $100 million.
So what's interesting here is you're not pitching for our money, you're pitching for our time.
Yep,
and which is a great concept because in some ways, I don't know about you guys, my time I consider way more valuable than my money.
As do we.
When I got your pitch, $22 million in sales, 3%, I invest nothing. That would be the best investment I will have ever made in my life, hands down.
Yes.
So. Agreed, it's my time, but I'm just saying, I'm pretty impressed with you guys.
I appreciate that, thank you.
Yeah.
So this sounds like it's gonna turn into a brawl about which one of us gets to make the best investment of a lifetime.
It's not a brawl when I'm the sure bet, okay? That's pretty much obvious at this point. Listen, they do have a lot to offer here, and that is true, but the difference between me and them as a mentor is I'm like y'all. I know what it's like to start a business with $24 in the bank. Both my parents were immigrants to this country, and I know what it's like to scrap for every single dollar. I also know what it's like to scale a company from $2 million to $200 million.
So let's lay a few things out. Okay, for one, I have cleaned more grills than these two ladies combined, I'm sure. Number two, I have 7 companies under my belt, and it's not the quantity, it's the fact, it's the diversity, it's the number of things I've encountered that I think can actually help you. One of the companies, in fact, focuses on the backyard. That is their whole market. They understand the people who buy grills and use grills, and I certainly have that experience. I mean, more importantly, I think I understand the subtleties of your business. I think I can predict the things you're gonna run into before you run into them.
I appreciate all of Mark's expertise, without a doubt, but I've been in the trenches for the last 2 years building consumer product brands and moving them at a very fast pace into retail, which is almost unheard of for new brands. So my expertise can help you take where you are today to where you want to go.
I can't believe we're pitching you. Can you believe this? I feel like, talk about the tables have turned.
Each of you share unique values, and we think that we can really grow this thing to the next level. Is there any way that we can get all 3 of you?
No.
No.
Absolutely not. Oh, come on.
We're gonna have to go with Kim.
This election has been rigged.
Thank you. Super pumped.
We're going. I'm going to the elevator with you. We're here. We're going down, and we'll see you guys later.
What just happened?
Are you so excited?
Very, very.
Just never give up on your dreams. If you have an idea, no idea is a bad idea. Just shoot for it.
Yeah, I mean, anybody watching this at home, like Scott said, I mean, this is real. It seems unreal, but this is reality. Like, this can happen. If this can happen to us, this can happen to you.
I guess we're left here with the grills, the hot sauce. It's been a good episode.
It's been a really good episode, and it's kind of fitting, you know?
It's kind of fitting, just the two of us at the end of it all, left here, the eye candy.
While three businesses were able to secure high-flying deals with our investors, two were sent back down to the bottom floor with nothing to show. Whether it's a new invention or a new way of living life, anyone could be 60 seconds away from rising to greatness or fall from glory. Tune in next week as five new entrepreneurs enter the elevator. But who will make it to the boardroom? And to apply for the next season, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Investors personally styled by celebrity stylist Kim Bolafay.